broadcast, Shahid Iqbal Choudhary. Zeenat is joining us live from Srinagar. She has Shahid Iqbal Choudhary with her. Let's go ahead and speak to him. Zeenat, over to you.
Yes, Niranjan, we have District Development Commissioner Srinagar Shahid Iqbal Choudhary with us. Shahid, thank you for talking to Republic. So, how do you view Prime Minister's today's address?
Starting with last month, the lockdown has always been a challenging task in these circumstances, where you have to ensure essential services, commodities, emergency management and medical health care. Our graded response started much earlier in second week of March. So now we are nearly into a month of lockdown and restrictions in Srinagar. The response has been amazing. Right now we have 51 cases, local residents, and another 19 cases, those who are not local residents but who are quarantined on their arrival. In 10 days, we faced some difficulties in reaching out to public, essential commodities, PDS, ration, LPG, other things. Now the system has evolved and fine-tuned. Now we have divided city into 25 zones. We are reaching out to the people. So with the extension of lockdown, definitely our responsibilities go up. And we are taking care of all the aspects, be it the patients, surveillance in field, special cases, maybe the labourer from outside the state who are with us, and other cases, including essential commodities and essential services delivery.
Shahid, what will be the first challenge, the important challenge, the greater challenge for at least for till 20th of April, as the Prime Minister has pointed out that strictly everything will be monitored because then only the guidelines will be maybe some relaxation?
Right now, particularly talking about this city, we are at a very critical stage. Right now, we are in effective command and control. We have all the positive cases well traced and tracked. Their history is documented and their contacts are traced. With 15 red zones across the Srinagar city, I think next 1 week to 10 days will be certainly crucial for us, where we have to maintain effective lockdown, and slowly we are just moving for opening of some shops in decentralized mechanism, like 2 to 3 shops in a particular zone. Responding to emergency issues and healthcare, that is certainly a challenge, but as I said, we have a decentralized system on the ground, so they will be responding to it.
So how are you dealing with the red zones and those where you have the more threats that will turn red zones?
The red zones have been completely locked. Say there are 20 to 30 entry exit points, so we have locked all except 2 to 3, where we have regulated entry and exit. Our people are sitting there, they just make an entry, who has to go inside, who has to come out, and we are maintaining strict standard operating procedure as laid down by the World Health Organization or issued by the local health authorities. Then the essential services and the important issues are addressed by the local committees, and we are ensuring this essential commodities and delivery of ration, LPG, everything in these red zones.
So how are you dealing with the migrant labourers, and what is the number that is in Srinagar district?
We have more than 15,000 migrant labourers at various locations across the city. Initially, we had provided 2 weeks ration to them and also established some community kitchens. Now, with the extension of lockdown, we are going into second round and providing them all assistance they require.
Thank you so much for talking to the public. Niranjan, that was DC Srinagar Shahid Iqbal Choudhary, who pointed out how they are going to work on red zones, the migrant labourers issue, and also the all essential services that will be on ground, and how the things will be monitored in next week.